Hey guys, I want to take a look with you at the case trapper in zebra wood and just give you a quick look around and talk about some of the features of this knife. It comes in the typical case American flag box. So what we are used to see from case, wrapped in this paper. I think it's a pretty good, still a pretty good presentation for a gift knife or something. Let's put this over here actually. And like I said, this is the zebra wood version. Zebra wood is basically can be a lot of different types of wood, so it's very likely this is probably South American, maybe Brazilian wood, and then it probably was colorized from case. But it has this really interesting texturing going on, and those lines inside the wood, as you can see. It looks interesting, it looks beautiful for somebody that likes the color green. This is definitely a winner. We have brass liners at the back and steel backspring and I think nickel silver bolsters. I'll show you the blade in the open position. This is the clip point blade. It obviously comes with two blades in this configuration here. And this is the spade blade. It's a little bit smudgy from me touching it. As you can see, the action is quite smooth. The spring is not as hard, so the blade doesn't over travel and hit the back spring, so that's good. Decently thin blade. It's not a large blade, but it's not overly small either. We have about 8.3 centimeters in the clip point, which is 3.2 inches. And then the spade blade is also 8.2 centimeter, so it's just a millimeter shorter, so like I said, 3.2 inches around that size. So it's large enough to do some of the larger tasks as well, but still relatively small and compact if you think about it. The only thing that I think is not that compact is maybe the weight. We have 99 grams, which is 3.4 ounces. So it's a little bit of heavier, although it doesn't feel heavy in hand. If I would, guess what the weight is, I wouldn't have guessed that it's 99 grams. It feels a little bit lighter than that. So yeah, with the closed length of 15 centimeters or 5.9 inches, you could actually carry that in if you have a larger fifth jeans pocket, you could carry it like that. Or, maybe buy a leather slip or something. No lanyard hole here, as you can see. Which is a bit of a bummer, but I guess that's fine. We have the traditional case shield here with the double stamp. I show you some size comparisons right away so you can see that. By the way, these measurements down here are in centimeters and not inches. So what do we have? I show you a traditional one, Buck 110. Buck 110 is a bigger knife, but as you can see, the case trapper is not as small, but the blade is quite a bit slimmer, so it's more of an elegant version, I guess, of the Buck 110, but different because it has no locking system and everything. Here is a standard Victorinox, which is the Victorinox Climber, so that's the same blade size as, the Farmer and the Pioneer, so completely the same. Blade size is this one, and then here we have the smaller Victorinox knife. This is the Cadet. Let me get this in frame real quick. Yeah, so this is the smaller Victorinox size. This is the medium size, so the normal one that you usually see. So as you can see, it's bigger than both of those, and I don't know, I'm not sure how much on the thickness we have, but I would guess it's like 2.5 millimeters or something, so decently thin. Fine point on the clip point here. And then with the spade blade, it's a little bit more robust, so it has more thickness up the tip. So I would say the spade blade lends itself more to harder using or, medium use. This is not a hard use, really hard use knife after all, but medium use, and then the clip point is a good user for fine tasks. As you can see, here we have the stamp on the blade, which is USA 724 54. 7 is the wood or the handle configuration, in this case the zebra wood, And then 2 means that we have 2 blades, and 5-4 is the model number. So 5-4 is the model number for the Trapper. I think it's a really beautiful knife. I do like the jig bones that these come in, but this green zebra wood also looks really, really nice in my opinion. There are a couple of imperfections with this knife. Obviously, like we used to know it from Case, there are always these tiny little scratches in the blades. So in the polish of the blades, there are always some very tiny, minor little scratches, same as on the bolsters. And on this blade, you can also see some more scratches up here. So there may be some imperfections, you know, out of the box. It's not 100% perfect. And also the edge is not perfect out of box. I sharpened this myself because I want to gift it to somebody and I didn't want to give them a dull knife. But the case edges that I have had in the last, you know, on all the case knives that I bought in the last couple of years, the edges were just really, really bad. I wish I had made a photo or a video when I received it, but you know, now I have already resharpened it myself. And at this point it is very, very sharp. But this is absolutely not how this comes out of the box. This is just how I resharpen it. So at this case, at this point it is scary razor sharp. But taking to consideration, if you want to give this to somebody or if you buy it for yourself, that you might, or you know, very likely have to resharpen it, because the edges from Case, like I said, are just terrible. I show you more size comparisons. Here is a Case Hawkbill pruner with the sway back handle. Also very, very beautiful knife. I mean, those two blades right there look so, so, so nice. This is one thing we have to say about Case. Here's another one, the Teardrop. Also beautiful Case knife. So this is one thing you can definitely say about Case. They give you a lot of color and blade options, and they just make, I think they make very attractive knives. As you can see here, I mean, these three are all really nicely looking. Beautiful cheekbone on this one. And then we have white bone on this one, which is smooth white bone with the red shield. Case always switches their shields like this. I would like it if they would have the shields, you know, the other way around, but I'm not sure why they do this. But yeah, in this case we have a blued blade. You can see some scratches in there already, but very beautiful knife also. But this zebra wood is a great example for how well Case does their handle scales. I think this is very nicely looking. Yeah, not as aggressive of the belly on the clip point here. I forgot to mention that. It's a little bit weird when sharpening. You have to run it at a weird angle, you know, when dragging it over a stone, because there is a lot that angle up here is quite steep. But I think it works really well in actual use, and I do like that clip point with that long drop to the point. It's very beautiful. And like I said, I think the clip point lends itself more for the finer tasks, and then you have the spade blade, which is sort of a user, like, also very, very pronounced belly here on the front. Yeah, this is the stainless steel configuration. I think they make the Trapper also in their carbon V steel, which means it's not, not stainless, basically. Has probably a little bit of better edge holding than this one. But the stainless is good, you know, for, in my opinion, as a gift knife to a person that is not, you know, doesn't care too much about his knives and, you know, doesn't always clean them properly. So I think the stainless works well for people that are not so much into knives and don't want to see a patina or something going on. So, yeah, this was just a quick look at the Case Trapper in zebra wood, and I think it's a beautiful knife. It carries way better than, you know, the weight suggests, and it's a great tool. Thank you guys for watching and have a nice day.